In this problem, we have a mixture that we're going to compare. So we have a mixture of A and B, and it says the activity coefficient of A is greater than 1 for essentially all values of the mixture. When we mix A with C, the activity coefficient of A is less than 1 for all values in the mixture. It wants us to plot fugacity, this fugacity of A, versus mole fraction of A for both of these mixtures, and label the axes. And then it says, if we were to have an ideal solution, we also would like to see how the fugacity would change. And it tells us that PA sat equals twice PB sat, and PA sat equals 3 times PC sat. So the fugacity of A in solution is the mole fraction of A, the activity coefficient, and the fugacity of A at standard conditions, which typically is going to be close to saturation pressure. So to a reasonable approximation for pure A, we could write this. So what we want to plot is the fugacity of A in mixture versus the mole fraction of A. Here's 0, here's pure A, and here would be pure B. So when we have no A, then the fugacity must be 0. When we have pure A, the fugacity must be the saturation pressure of A. And if this were ideal, right, we would have a straight line. So this line is ideal, right? Now, if we look at AB solution and gamma is greater than 1, it just says the fugacity is going to be above this line. And of course, it has to approach be equal. So this fugacity of A in the AB mixture, and that's true because gamma is greater than 1. So in this equation, we're going to be above the ideal solution. When gamma is less than 1, like the AC solution, then we must be below. So again, we have to approach the pure material. So this fugacity of A in an AC solution.